Kang, what the fuck happened to Kevin Smith after he went vegan? I mean, eat whatever the fuck you want. Sure, most vegans wind up looking like a Christian Children's Fund commercial, but we've all seen stories of some genetic super freak who can cut out gluten, dairy, meat, poultry, seafood, caffeine, and calories and still be built like Colossus. But Kevin Smith looks like he's timesharing at Mauthausen. I haven't seen cheekbones like that outside of Sloan Kettering. And who knew this dude was storing all his writing talent in his stomach? Before his sickle cell makeover, Kevin Smith was known for pioneering comic book runs on Daredevil, Green Arrow, and of course fountain his fuckloads of slice of life dramedies at the Cinemaplex, such as Clerks, Clerks 2, and Clerks Hard with a Vengeance. After he started ignoring the evolutionary imperative of human beings forming fucking canine incisors for the purposes of tearing cooked flesh, yeah. He's known rather ironically for Tusk, thinly veiled propaganda piece Red State, and of course the Pawn Stars of pseudo-geek cringe culture, Comic Book Men, also known as that scripted reality garbage that would have been shit-canned after 5 episodes if it hadn't had The Walking Dead as a lead-in. Deal with it. Seriously, Kev, what the low-carb, gluten-free fuck happened to you? Guardian Devil is one of the best comic books I've ever read. This she-woman and the gashters of the Pooniverse shit wouldn't fly with Zeppelin tits. It's the same shit that happened to Peter Jackson. After crafting his fantasy magnum opus, Lord of the Rings, he dropped 15 pant sizes, got more political than George Takei's Twitter feed, and pinched out The Hobbit. One movie in 3 fucking parts. Who knew you stopped being able to make trilogies after your chin stopped being one? I mean, are we sure Kevin Smith is actually a hack now and not merely suffering from fucking malnutrition? Because I caught a podcast he did. You remember the podcast that hasn't been worth a shit since it stopped being about Batman? Totaling over 2 titty-twisting hours, at least 45 full minutes of which were devoted to Kevin coping with the public hacklash.
The folks upstairs, like, put it on Front Street. And this is not me being a dick, man. This is just me kind of explaining, like, how counterproductive it is to go all in against something you hate. Their reaction was like, Kevin, this is amazing for the show. And I was like, yeah, but all these people are mad. They were like, yes, it looks like about 5,000 to 10,000 people have written nasty things. And they were like, but we have 210 million subscribers. And I was like, oh, so mathematically we're safe. They're like, safe as kittens. So, but I do know this much, based on what I was told by the people that like pay my salary, that doesn't matter to them. Like they literally don't care.
And here's the thing, he's fucking right, folks. Look, He-Man is a dormant fucking property, one many millennials, including myself, weren't born in time to actually enjoy. The last proper cartoon series was canceled with extreme prejudice after just 1.5 seasons. To put a finer point on it, this ain't Star Wars. This shit ain't gonna advertise itself. It needs legions of untold legions of online discussions parsing every fucking frame of this show to serve as walk and talk and billboards for this bullshit. Sort of kind of like every other clickbait merchant on the motherfucking interwebs devoting 20.5 episodes to the series just to say it sucks. But then in the very same podcast, I also caught this.
I just finished a 7-day fast. I have not eaten since after we did Fat Man Beyond last week. And it was amazing. I feel fantastic. I'm all fucking cleaned out and shit like that. But I had, right before I came here, I had a bowl of tomato soup. And you would have thought like I got to, you know, fuck Bo Derek in the 80s or something like that. It was like the most delicious fucking bowl of soup I've ever had.
Starving yourself for a fucking week only to break your fast with fucking tomato soup? Enjoy your stomach ulcer, by the way, asshole. Either way, are we sure this basset hound looking boomer is actually losing his writing abilities and not just fucking starving to death? I doubt Hemingway could have cranked out anything of consequence if he spent his entire career on the Chilean miner diet. And just how tan are you planning on getting exactly, Kevin? If you told me in 2005 that 15 years from now, Sammy Sosa would be whiter and way more than Kevin Smith, I would have asked for the number of your shroom dealer, dipshit. I'm not even gonna lie, for a minute there, I thought I accidentally clicked on the Flavor Flav podcast. And this ain't the delirious ravings of a developmentally arrested incel He-Man fan for life, because Kang, I ain't even that old. I wasn't a bead of nut sweat on the sack of my progenitor when He-Man and Skeletor were having slap fights in Castle Grayskull. In other words, consider this the delirious ravings of a developmentally arrested incel Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles fan for fucking life. So take that, shit dicks! And yes, I fully appreciate the irony of me making a video in order to tell you not to make videos about this vomitous fucking nonsense. But folks, I've been around. I've seen controversies come and controversies go down in fucking flames. I know of what I speak when I say hatred sometimes sells tickets. Apathy, on the other hand, ends a fucking franchise. It wasn't the hatred toward The Last Jedi that assassinated Star Wars. It was the apathy afforded Solo in the immediate and consequent aftermath. I said it when Sarkeesian showed up, so feel free to go back and fucking confirm it. If you continue to snarkify and fucking hate watch, this bitch will be bigger than Elvis. If, on the other hand, you ignore her ass, she could be gone next fucking month. Well, that was January of 2014, and it only took, two more years of an entire YouTube genre of skeptic-cunt Sarkeesian exploitation and people pretending Thunderfoot is fucking talented for folks to finally get the memo I made at the very beginning, at which point, she vanished like a Clinton witness. And so did her audience. Checked in on Feminist Frequency's channel lately, you'd see a bigger crowd at an agoraphobe convention. Folks, the opposite of love is not hate. It's indifference. And I, for one, indifference the living shit out of Kevin Smith's Masters of the Motherfucking Universe. I'm Razor Fist. God fucking speed.
People judge you by many things. Your appearance, your honesty, the way you act. Those things show your character. When you make a promise and don't keep it, it shows bad character. So always think before you speak and mean what you say. That way what you say will be respected. See you again soon.